Guys, welcome back to a brand new video. Today I'm going to be getting into this amazing 3-pack that I got from Amazon. I'm going to say right now, because at the end of the video I think I forgot the pricing of it, but it cost me around $86 altogether for this 3-pack. I'm going to say anywhere from like $86 to about $95 to make sure to have on you to get this 3-pack online, just to make sure. But I think it was $86 in total. I'm pretty sure that's how much it was. The price on the website is $79.99. But you're probably going to spend about anywhere from $86 to $90, depending on shipping and handling and where you're getting it from, or where you're located and where it's going to. But yeah, this is a really, really cool set. I can't wait to get into. So here we go. Let's get into this. All right, guys. So before we get into the unboxing, I have to take a second to just appreciate the back. You can see we have Phantom X over there to the left. In the middle, we have Nimrod. And then we have Miss Psylocke over there to the side. I really like these images of these three. I just think the back of this box looks so cool, and I really hope that these figures continue to do this. I really want to make like sort of a poster with these. I just think they look really cool. Well, I just like the way the characters look. I love that image of Phantom X over there in the corner. I like the way his eyes pop out. His mask looks really, really cool. His headpiece. It's funny because, like, you know, he and Psylocke look just very realistic and, you know, human. And then you have Nimrod, who just looks like a completely animated character, versus these two who look really real. I mean, look at the detail in these photos. They almost look like they are just straight up actual people who took these photos. That's how cool they look. I would say probably especially Phantom X versus Psylocke. He looks 100% real. Psylocke does look really real as well, but there is sort of an animated quality to her. Maybe it's because her whole entire face is exposed, where he only has a section of his face exposed. I don't know, but the detail in his face is just, it's very human-like, and of course hers is too, but his just looks a lot less animated than hers, but hers is just amazing. I mean, her, like, honestly, to me, this picture, I feel like Psylocke steals the show, no question. Like, when I first saw the image of this, I'm like, I'm keeping the box. I don't always keep their boxes, but I'm definitely keeping this box. And guys, without further ado, let's get right into this unboxing. Here we go. And here we have Phantom X. Super cool. I want to say the show I remember him from is, I believe, Wolverine and the X-Men. I think that was the show that he was in. If not, it was X-Men Evolution, but I'm pretty sure it was Wolverine and the X-Men is when I first saw Phantom X. He looked different from this, but very, very cool. I'm loving the black and the white. I think there's a Spider-Man that looks like this, or maybe it's a Venom. I'm pretty sure it's Spider-Man, but he looks really, really cool. Very reminiscent of that figure, the one I'm talking about. Love the colors. Since I love black and white. To me, black and white looks really clean together, and I just like the way that this character ended up turning out. And I was super excited for this character. When I saw the art for him, and Psylocke, I was like, man, I can't wait to get my hands on this character. The art really made me want to get this character, and I'm glad I did. He looks really cool. I kind of show you him up close. Very nice. You can see what he looks like. Super cool. Movement for him is not too difficult. He's actually really easy to move as a Psylocke. Again, because they're newer, they have a little bit of a stiffness to them. They're not as, like, they're flexible, but they're not as flexible as one that's kind of, you know, been, you know, in constant use and constant setups and poses and stuff. Very cool. He does come with two guns, and both of them do have like the shooting effect, which is cool. I just wanted him to only, yeah, support the one in this. But yeah, this is very, very cool. You can see here is the back. Very, very nice. Love that. And the jacket is very similar to like Multiple Man's jacket, jackets like that are kind of the longer ones. Gambit's jacket. I think this is Gambit's jacket, actually. Very, very cool. They all have like the no sleeve thing going on. So it's very similar to both of those jackets. So pretty awesome. In fact, he's probably one of their bodies, actually. He's probably no different. And then, of course, you have little holsters that he can put the guns into, so he doesn't always have to sport them. Just very, very nice. Very cool. I would actually love to have a maskless head too with him. I think that would have made sense to have him to the side, a cool pose. But yeah, I would have loved it. That would have been really, really cool as well to have that with this figure. Here's kind of the boots and everything. Really, really nice. Good paint job, everything like that. But yeah, I think his eyes could have been a little bit more of a blue. Like, they're a nice blue, definitely, but like, I think on the box they really did stand out. That's probably the one thing that's different. But yeah, I mean, a second head would have been kind of cool. I might even just kind of make my own
have like my own second head for him, I'll think of something to do, because I think that'd be kind of cool. And then what if I do that, I will show you in another video just kind of an update thing of who I decided to choose for his second head. But yeah, really cool. Okay, so here we have Psylocke just with all of her stuff with her gadgets. She comes with a lot of cool stuff. I was really impressed with this figure and just how much she comes with. She comes with a second hand. I think one that you can like ball, like just one that's like just a pure fist. So you can do both fists for both hands instead of one holding a sword, which is really cool. I thought she could have come with two instead of just the one, that way she can hold things in both hands. But she doesn't really need to hold the sword, I guess, in her left hand, but still the option would have been kind of cool to have that. But you can see she comes with different little pieces there. Her sword looks amazing. I love her sword. I just like the way that they have it looking, the effects of the sword. I love the other effect that she has with her other blade and her other hand. And then of course I love that she has her powers on like full display of what she can do. Really, really cool. I also love the purple, how it adds to, you know, just her overall look. And there's like a theme with this three pack, which is really cool. The theme, I think, is it's black and white. You can see that she has the most black on her out of all the three, where I don't think Nimrod has very much black on him at all. And she only has like the white sash. But then you have Phantom X, who's a good cross between both. He's wearing a lot of white, but he's also wearing a lot of black too. So that's kind of cool that they have like, that is sort of the theme of the two pack. Everyone kind of just works together. Also, her and Nimrod both have a lot of like purple and sort of pinkish hues in them as well. So I think that just kind of makes for a really cool set. The color scheme seems to kind of flow a lot better than most two packs or even three packs. Very, very cool. Here is a close-up of Psylocke. I really want you guys to see how great she looks. She looks amazing. Very, very cool. I'm not gonna waste too much time showing you like a long side profile. I'm just gonna show you kind of, there's the side of her. Very nice. Here's the back of her. You can see the hair. I love the hair. I like all the different colors. Like you go kind of like dark at the root, kind of go a little bit lighter, back to the dark, a little bit light, and then back to the dark. Very nice. Love that. And then you can see here to the other side, it has a really, really good side profile. She looks great. And then back to the front. Yeah, she looks really, really good. I'm gonna show you her too with all the stuff off of her so you can just see what it looks like. But yeah, very, very cool here. She is with all the other stuff off of her. Yeah, I really love Psylocke. As a kid, I always wanted a Psylocke toy. I remember collecting a lot of the X-Men figures as a child, and there was a Psylocke on the back of one of the boxes. And I really wanted that character. I've always liked Psylocke for whatever reason. She's always been one of my favorites. Not only one of my favorite females, but just one of my favorite characters in general. I actually, like, in my mind, I kind of ship her and Bishop. I don't know what that's about, but I always kind of have. I think her, Bishop, and like Forge would go on like amazing missions together. That's just how I see it. But I also like not ship her with Scott, but I can see her hanging out with Scott and like Wolverine and stuff like that. So she's really cool. And I also love that her brother is Captain Britain. I do have Captain Britain as well, so I'm gonna go ahead and put them next to each other. If not, put her next to Bishop and Forge. But yeah, she looks amazing, very, very cool. The one of the character I really wanted in this three pack, because I don't have a Psylocke, that's Marvel Legends. I have a Marvel Select one, but in that one looks amazing too. But I really wanted this character. And here we have Nimrod, very, very cool. I like this figure a lot, super awesome. He does come with closed fists as well, which I will show you that too, and a second head that is more of like a magenta color. A very, very cool figure, a bigger figure. I love my bigger figures. I don't know why, but I love the bigger figures. I just do. So cool to have this figure. Very nice. I like how clean he looks. Got the kind of magenta pink going on with the white. Very, very nice. The like wings in the back and stuff, super cool. And those are detachable. You can't take that off. But yeah, I really like this figure a lot. I'm gonna show you up close, and I'll show you the second head and the other hands as well. Here, this is Nimrod. I mean, just look, dude. Like, honestly, out of the three of them, I was the most excited to get my hands on like a Marvel Legends Psylocke, but I ended up loving both the other characters too, Phantom X and of course Nimrod. Like I said, I love the bigger figures. He is such a cool figure. He can bend everything like that. Super awesome. Look at that bend. Very nice from the top and from the bottom. Very cool. Look at these hands, just all of this. Just look at all of it, man. This is so awesome. And again, you can take the back piece off too, kind of the spine. Very cool. Yeah, it feels so nice. And it's actually a different color from the rest of him. Like this is more of a like sort of a magenta color. This is a different kind of pink there. Very nice. Almost a reddish too, yeah. Look at the feet. Very cool. I love this, man. This is really cool. I love the head, the shape of the head too. Everything about this character is really cool. I love this, like, sort of reminds me of Iron Man. Very nice. I love it. I'm not very versed on some of these characters, to be honest. I love the X-Men. The X-Men is my favorite, but I'm not gonna lie, I'm not very versed on Nimrod. So I don't know if there's like a whole reason why he has like the Tony Stark sort of like thing here. I don't know what that's about. I'm sure some of you guys in the comments do. I really got this set because I like Psylocke and I did like Phantom X from what I had seen him in before, but I thought Nimrod was so cool, like, just not to not get as a part of the set. So I really do like this character. Now I'm kind of invested in learning more about Nimrod, and sometimes that happens. Sometimes the figures that you collect, you end up kind of getting more into them after having like the figure. So very cool. All right, and here's his second head, and you can see the second hands too that are just close fists. Very, very nice. I do like the second head because it does match the back of him as well. You can see that I've also taken off like the spine. Very, very cool. I would definitely recommend, well, obviously you kind of have to do this, taking off the spine piece before reattaching the heads. Definitely do that first. Otherwise, it's just going to be kind of weird to put back on. But yeah, super cool. Let me show you the arms spread out. They can spread out about that far. Very nice. And the wing, the head is very easy to take off. I was nervous that the head would be kind of hard to take off. It's not. It's very, very easy to take off and put back on. So good job, Marvel, with this. Good job, Hasbro, with this. Very, very cool. I like this figure quite a bit. Like I said, I love the heaviness. It's a heavy figure. It's a good figure. It's making me really excited for the Sentinel that I have coming. Yes, I did buy a Sentinel. Your boy had to get it. I had to get a Sentinel. Like, I had to get a Sentinel. I just wanted to make sure that that was going to be one of the things that I ended up getting. And luckily enough for me, I did. I know some people who got several of them. So kudos to you guys. I just really wanted the one. And I just thought, like, it'd be so cool. Like, it's, I don't know. Sentinels, I think, are such a huge part of the X-Men. When I think of the X-Men, I think of villains. Like, of course, I think of, like, Magneto and stuff. But I definitely think of the Sentinels, no question. So I'm really excited. And I think I'm getting all three. So that's, I think everyone who's getting is getting all three, right? I think that's the thing. But yeah, really cool. Very excited for that. And I'm going to show you all of them together. All right, folks, and this is them all together. Again, we have Phantom X, we have Nimrod, and we have Psylocke. Showed you all their pieces that they come with. Super duper dope. You guys, I'm really, really impressed with this set, I have to say. One of my favorites, absolutely. I really like the Rogue and Pyro 2-pack, no question, but I think this one is even cooler. You guys can get this one on Amazon. That's the only place that I know of it being as of right now. I don't think it's on the Hasbro website, but I mean, you can always check that. But I believe this one was exclusive to Amazon. I'm pretty sure that was the whole thing about that. And what's really cool was it was supposed to come out in November, and they ended up like really speeding it up, obviously, now because it's September and I'm doing this now. So very, very cool. Really impressed with this 3-pack. And guys, I want to say thank you so much for all of your likes, follow, subscribes. Thank you for sharing. If you are not subscribed to the channel yet, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button. Make sure to ring that bell for notifications. Leave me a nice big like on this video. Let me know that you guys like the content that I'm coming up with. I appreciate all the love that you guys are showing the channel. I appreciate all the new subscribers. Hi guys, what's up? Thank you so much for subscribing to the channel. That means so much to me. I do have a lot of Bring Arts Kingdom Hearts figures. I think I still have some that I haven't done yet. So we'll get into Axel and stuff like that. I'm going to get back into Funko's pretty soon as well. So this is just going to be kind of a collection channel. I'm just going to show you all the things that I really enjoy. But yeah, guys, I'll see you guys in the next one. Until then, have a marvelous day. Peace.